కర్ణ పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎథర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 9 ఆఫ్ 7 చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ పుణ్యో గంధ పృథివ్యాంచ తేజశ్చాస్మి విభావసౌ జీవనం సర్వభూతేషు తపశ్చాస్మి తపస్విషు. భగవాన్ కంటిన్యూస్, ద గ్లోరీ ఆఫ్ ఈశ్వర స్వరూపం ఇస్ రివీల్డ్ ఇన్ దీస్ వర్సెస్. వి సా ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ సెషన్ ద గాడ్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ద కాజ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ వేదాస్. ఇన్ ద సేమ్ వే హియర్ ఎవ్రీ ఎలిమెంట్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ గాట్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ తన్మాత్ర. తన్మాత్ర మీన్స్ ద రియల్ నేచర్, that which makes water into water, that which makes earth into earth, that originality. The space has got one tanmatra, that is known as sound. And vayu has got his own tanmatra, sparsha, means touching sense, but it also includes the tanmatra of the space. It means what? Two characteristics, two gunas belong to the air, vayu. Touching sense and sound. The fire has got three, and the specified tanmatra of the fire is heating principle. And also it includes what? Sound and touching sense, sparsha, sabda, sparsha, and it has got rupa. So rupa also kept with the fire alone. When there is a light, then alone you can see something. And heat principle also belongs to fire. Okay, the heat is the nature of the fire. Then the fourth one is water. So water contains the four natures. Water has got a rasaha, but water is main in our physical system, isn't it? The moisture. And one kid asked me, Swamiji, why do we love the place where water exists? It's a very valuable question. And why do we also love by seeing the greeneries? If your house is situated in the garden, you will have a pleasant health, pleasant psychological health, and you will also have a kind of healthy transaction with the people. Is there any connection? Why do we love the water? Because our physical system is 70% contains waterly aspect. Therefore, by the natural itself, naturally we love to be endowed with martial conditions. But if it is too much moisture, then you will become sick. In the same way, when we go into a garden in the forest, when you get a kind of greenery around you, your eyes, your brain, everything becomes calm and it settles in the calmness. Do you know what the science behind it? These all greeneries, they symbolize vitamins, minerals, and nourishments. All nutritions are available, therefore automatically you are pulled. But if you don't have a healthy system, you are pulled, attracted towards this all colored food. This colored food means what? Unhealthy fast foods. I call it fast food because fast is not the proper usage. Fast food. Because it collapses our digest system. We have to have taste in our buds. This all colored food collapses our system. Therefore, we have to be careful with that. But here, Every element has got its tanmatra. That tanmatra is nothing but me. That tanmatra, when that kid asks these questions, I could think that even a small kid can also think. So what is going on in our understanding? Why are we attracted towards the water? Because so our earth itself 70% water and body itself containing 70% of water. And not only that, this idea, so which we see in a kid, that is developed as the inquiry in all the aspects of the life. Now the perception which we are talking about, this seeing world as Ishvara, it is not a faking and making it. Some people say, when you see the God will be generated. I myself said long back, do you remember? But that is in the preliminary stage. It's a primary stage, so in which you are cultivating yourself to fix yourself with the realization, the process of the realization of the God. You need not to see world as the God, because world is already God. It is not dependent on your perception. That's what I'm keep on telling. You should keep in your mind. Now when he says the earth has got fragrance, that fragrance is me. Now you cannot separate the earth and the fragrance. The fragrance is the nature, it's a tanmatra. Now because this creation, what we call it world is endowed with fragrance, not with the bad smell. Bad smell only comes because we pollute the environment. If you keep environment healthy, means what? We should not pollute them. Even this body has got natural cycling in the same way. The nature also has got its own cycling. We should not pollute by inventing so many non-perishable things. Easily, the polythenes are not perishable. We can even apply all the quality of the Brahman or Maya to the polythene. We invented the polythene, but it is not decaying. It takes long term. It can spoil the nature, the phenomenon and cycling of the earth system. He says, Gandhavati Prithvi, that Tattva. Tattva Bodha says, Gandhavati Prithvi. The Prithvi has got smell, no other elements. You may ask, so what about water? So we get this tap water, sometimes the fragrance, it feels it's like a cremation ground. No, the water has got Prithvi content. Prithvi is polluted, therefore that smell is coming in that way. That a fall is because of the fault of the human being. Any disease he is affected by doesn't matter. If you bury him, the disease is demolished. Body is digested by the Prithvi and smell also won't come up. Because Prithvi, the place of this smell, therefore what? The Prithvi can suck, it can swallow. If you dump anything, the smell won't come out. That's what Prithvi is nature. That the nature, which is the fragrance of Prithvi, that's me. Punya Gandha means, because the nature is endowed with a healthy environment, that's what Bhagavan means. Tejas chasmi vibhavasau. Vibhavasau means fire. I am the heat principle in the fire. You remove the heat principle. In fact, that heat principle alone, it penetrates in so many aspects. If you heat the water, the fire penetrates into the water as the heat principles. And it withdraws the water. It means it sucks the water and sends to Vayu. Keep boiling the water, it evaporates. And where all water content goes? It goes and it merges with the air. Therefore, he says, heat principle is the main content, means the cause of the fire. That cause of the fire is nothing but me. It means what? Fire is also nothing but me. And fire also, it burns everything. If a body is burnt, if you go to crematorium, whatever the smell after burning, only ash will remain. Because that prithvi, it withdraws that smell, then this all form is withdrawn from the fire, because the fire can make you formless. The rupa belongs to the fire. Fire can deform you. Therefore, tejaha ahamasmi. I am the heat principle in the heat. And body has the fire content. If you go to Tapovan, once I went to Tapovan, my God, you can feel everything around is in the minus degree. Your body should have the heatness. That heat principle, you can experience it. All the yogis, they can increase the heat principles. Expanding or increasing the heat so they could sustain in the cold places. They were not using the sweater, inners and no, nothing. We were looking like a Neil Armstrong with all the material, you know, when we go to beyond Kedar Badri. But they remain, they know how to increase them, how to get control over that principle, the five elemental aspects of the individual system. The next line, Bhagavan says, Jivanam sarva bhuteshu tapaschasmi tapasvishu. Sarva bhuteshu jivanam ahamasmi. I am the very life principle of all the being. Very life principle means what? Here he talks about the energy which is also known as prana. If somebody passes away, we say the pranan has gone. That pranan, it means what? It's a vayu. So pranan chala gaya. Pranan poindi. Pranan phadut. This pranan alone, the life. That pranam is me. And everybody has got his own level of prana. And you will be amazed. You know, an elephant, it has got its own pranic powers. But lion has got its own potential power. This energy, you know, the way with the big, huge, gigantic figure, the elephant has got its own tremendous power. You could see this Dhritarashtra said to be hundreds of elephant power which he had. We calculate, you know, this horse power. Horse power, 10 HP means what? It's a 10 horse power. That power is nothing but me. If a person could sing well, if a person could run well, if a person could throw well, all these sportsmen, prana-oriented lifestyle people. Jivanam sarva bhuteshu. The life is expanded by this prana. That prana is nothing but me means what? He has got the hold of our prana. He can stop whenever he wants to stop. Every breath is counted. We don't know which is the last breath which goes out and comes back. But we don't worry, because we are very confident people, as though we are living for 300 years. And some of them also planning for more than 100 years. Doesn't matter. But you have to achieve through the human body. A flower which comes up, means which is manifested in the forest, it reaches its completeness. No obstructions. If enough air and water and the sunlight is available, the sapling becomes a complete tree or complete plant for fruit or flower. So it will get a completeness, but only the human being. You provide all kinds of vitamins, minerals and even the educations, something in between goes wrong. They themselves create health. Because the human minding has got positive energy and negative aspects too. Therefore, he says, I am the prana. I am the prana means the life source in all the being. Okay? Then tapaschasmi tapasvishu. The tapasvi means ascetic people, saintly people. They are endowed with what? Their lifestyle is something different. They don't give priority to their likes and dislikes. They live a life with the attitude, with a concept or a principle, willful self-denial actions. Long back, I explained, tapas means what? Willful self-denial actions or will or a kind of lifestyle. They live in a Himalayas where, you know, you cannot, it's like a too cold. You cannot be there for long. Even in Rishikesh in January, December, November, December, January, you should have heater in the room, you should, have more layers of sweaters and all these caps and all, with the gloves and with the socks. But they don't wear anything. Means what? They select a lifestyle which is not giving priority for the comforts. They keep this old comforts out. They select a path, so which seems to be very discomforts for others, but they select. That is tapas. That tapas has got a kind of power. It can burn all karma phalas. That tapas is me. Tapasvi naam means a tapasvishu aham tapaha. I am the austerity. I am the saintliness. That is the saintliness. Some of them, they observe maunam for long. I have seen one tapasvi, he never talks. He doesn't talk at all. Maunam. Observance of maunam. It's a tapas. Then the next words, we'll read it. Bijam maam sarva bhutanam vidhi partha sanatanam buddhir buddhimatam asmi jastejasvi namaham. Maam vidhi, please understand me as the eternal seed of all being. Bijam sarva bhutanam bijam iti maam vidhi. I am the seed of all creation. What does he mean? There is one more concept called Hiranyagarbha in Vedanta, from where everything comes. So that's the Karana Sharira of the cosmic body. That I have not brought here, so we will see in the 9th chapter. So one more method of understanding the creation. So beautiful. That's steps, you know. It's like a math. You can enjoy it. But you know what I feel? So when the God concept is presented properly by Bhagavan Krishna, so sometimes mind becomes mum to accept it because it's so subtle beyond our understanding capacity. So only the grace of Guru and Ishvara will help to digest it. Therefore, you know, always we have to be endowed with some kind of parayana, chanting or some kind of puja. Nitya Nainityika Karya will help you to gain a proper ekagrata chittam. Therefore, every one of us who wants to study Bhagavad Gita, they have to practice yoga, practice little bit meditation, which was told in the 6th chapter. Every day should be spent with at least little bit amount of meditation. We have to have the knowledge called Aham Brahmas. So that's what lifestyle. Now bijam maam means I am the cause of everything. It seems to be mango tree has got mango seed as the cause. Neem tree has got neem seed as the cause. The seed are different. Because so my parents are different than your parents. Their parents are different than others' parents. So this all the causes. So it seems to be many numbers. They are innumerable, but he says, I am the seed. I am the seed of all seeds. I am the seed of all. The seed means what? The universe manifests into only four ways. The four ways what? Udbijam, Andajam, Jarayujam, Shvetajam. The world is manifested from the seed, from the womb, from an egg, and from the sweating. So when you dump all these waste materials, there you could see there is a kind of humidity. From there you can see so many worms, it will come out. So like the world manifestation happens from one seed. He alone the seed. Therefore, the eternal seed of all being is me. It means what? Every one of us are from the same seed. Even all planets, plants, creatures, all these birds and the creatures under the sea, and on the earth, in the space, everything from one seed. But here it is not talking about a Big Bang theory. We have to realize it. And that seed is also Sanatanam. There is one word. Sanatanam means which doesn't have beginning or end. He is continuously being, is going to continue as the seed alone. So every day comes out and day goes in, isn't it? We become substratum of our day experience and night experience and dream experience. In the same way, everything goes into Bhagavan and it comes out. For he is the seed. Okay? Then, Buddhir Buddhimatam Asmi Tejas Tejasvi Namaham. I am the intelligence of intelligence. It means what? So, if anybody is extraordinary intelligent, so that intelligent person may get a kind of proudness. But Bhagavan says, your intelligence is not yours, it's mine. And also he will continue. Aham tejaha tejasvinam. And the boldness among the bold. You know this, it comes in the next lines. The brilliance of boldness of the bold people is nothing but me. Valor of valorous people. Now if a person has got extraordinary brilliance, he should not get proud. And one more thing also you should understand. He is going to say all this in the next verse itself, balam balavatam chaham. And the strength among the strengthful people, strongest people. It means all these glorifying energy levels, our potential capacity, are the cause which is the cause of so many potential powers. He says, all of them are nothing but me. See, if a person has got intelligence, he should not become proud, because he should not also use that intelligence for criminal activity. It won't help for him. By the intelligence, by the boldness, by the strength. So he mentions all the strength, you know. The physical strength is balam. And this mental, psychological strength is the boldness. And the intellect aspect, strength is considered as, you know, intelligence. All of them are nothing but me. The same thing told by Acharya in one place, Adi Shankara. Ma kuru dhana jana yavana garvam harati nimeshat kala sarvam. So the garvam is gamanda, the proudness, ego. It comes because of the strength. If we have muscle strength, you will get a kind of ego. I will face whoever, doesn't matter. If he has money strength, then also a kind of, you know, the courage people get. And if a person is too intelligent, then he has got his own subtle ego. Now, my dear, if you have the strength, is provided by Lord alone according to your karma phala. If you use those strength for wrong things, they don't help you. You should take the example of Vali, Ravana, and so many asuras, Hiranyakashipu, Narakasura. So all demons, so Mahishasura, so many demons, they were very strongest people. Even Ravaneshwara had the old Navagraha as the steps of his crown. Every day he has to climb on them. So that much potential capacity which he had, but with wrong usage, he lost everything. Now if you have the strength, whether it is mental strength or the intellectual strength, or your physical strength, be endowed with humility. That humility, because no strength belongs to us. Only it belongs to Lord Ishvara. Okay? That's what he says. Buddhihi buddhimatam. Buddhimatam buddhihi ahamasmi. Tejasvinam tejaha ahamasmi. Balam balavatam balam ahamasmi. Kama raga vivarjitam balam ahamasmi. We will continue this verse, verse number 11, in the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om, Shri Guru Bhyo Namo Namaha. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om, Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.